So thankful to be out here as Alaska Native person, hunting the archaeological district. I'd like to thank the Athabascan Denali tribe that has been hunting here for 6,000 to 10,000 years. Apologize for not knowing the exact tribe, but this is a historical area that the Caribou have been migrating through, forever, time immemorial, and it's just amazing. They come here, and it's an easy hunt. You either sneak up on them or you wait for them to come to you. I did both. I snuck up on one, and as I was butchering it, I couldn't stand it and shot another one for my dad that was 80 yards away. It's kind of like the Wild Wild West, though. You got all these cowboys just firing all over the place, and the herd is literally ping-ponging from hunter to hunter throughout the valley. It's just insane. At one point, I had a bumblebee, and that's a supersonic bullet making the sound as it went by my head. That usually happens out here from these cowboys firing off, and I know I do the same thing, but I'm trying not to. You got to remember not to shoot over ridges. You don't know where people are. It's just a free-for-all. This is the Wild Wild West. It's nice of the state to allow families to come out here and fill their freezers. Like I said, the hunt is really fun and easy, but once you get your caribou, you're screwed. It just destroys your back and your knees because you gotta haul 90 pounds of meat and gear back and forth 3 to 5 miles over mountains and swamps. And it just is very painful. I've been training all summer for it, and it's still almost too much for me to handle. But in the end, you get a bunch of meat for very cheap, and it's also the experience of a lifetime.
So it was really special for me to get my caribou with an M1 Garand, a 1943 M1 Garand from World War II. Patton said it was whatever the greatest battle implement ever devised, but it's so accurate and it's the best hunting rifle. I will probably only hunt caribou with an M1 Garand from now on. It was just flawless. I shot one caribou in the neck, the other one right in the face. They both just dropped instantly. Couldn't believe how reliable and accurate it was. It was tough as nails. I could throw it around and, you know, set it in the wet grass and everything. It was just incredible. I will always hunt with an M1 Garand.
Yeah, so if you're a true outdoors person and you're hunting caribou on the Denali Highway, you have no choice but to stop and catch some grayling. In my opinion, this is the best fly fishing in the world. I know I've heard there's better places, but I haven't been to any. This is my personal favorite spot in the world, my little piece of heaven. The grayling are huge. Never seen grayling this big, and you just catch them really easily. It's so isolated out here. So yeah, if you're a true outdoors person, even though your knees and back are killing you and you've just been walking 20 miles a day through the mountains hunting caribou, you gotta stop and fly fish for grayling before you leave. It's just not worth it if you don't. Oh man, do you mind coming over here for the shot?
He's probably sitting with a beer down, huh? I hooked that with a beer in my hand, though.
Not bad.
That's talent, right? Yeah!
I guess grayling do jump. Fish.
I know, buddy. I'm trying to get it out.
That's what she said.
Oh, there it goes. Wow.
Video as well. Double hookup. I got one. He's got one. Ultimate fishing spot.
This is a small one. This is